I'm sure most of you have experienced this at least once in their life, especially if you often listen to music on your computer. Some keyboards have complicated key combinations for changing the volume. What if there was an easier and more intuitive way to accomplish this task? Well, there is. I present to you the USB volume knob. This cool little device allows you to change the volume on your computer by only using one hand and without complicated key combinations. In this video, I'll show you how you can build your own one at home. For the build, you'll need an Arduino Pro Micro that uses the ATmega32U4 as the main MCU. You'll also need a rotary encoder, 3 1K resistors, 2 12-pin male and 2 female pin headers, a large piece of perf board, and some wires. And even though most of the work is done by the software, the rotary encoder still needs to be connected to the Arduino. The circuit needs 3 pull-down resistors. This way the GPIO pins won't enter an undefined state. Connect one side of the resistors to ground in parallel. Now connect the 2 5V pins of the encoder to the 5V output of the Arduino. The other side of the 3 resistors will each go to one data line of the encoder and also to one of 3 GPIO pins of the Arduino. That's the entire circuit for this simple device. Now it's time to build the circuit. Start by cutting the perf board into 2 small pieces so that they have the same footprint as the Arduino. Then solder the encoder to one of the pieces and scrape away the traces between the 2 sides of the encoder, if necessary. Connect the 2 5V lines of the rotary encoder together. Add 4 cables afterwards. These will be the 2 data lines, the 5V line and the button's data line. Try to keep these wires as short as possible. Continue by preparing the second perf board by mounting the 3 resistors and the cables. Solder in the resistors and then connect one side of them to ground. You can make this step a lot easier by using the legs of the resistors to route the signal on the perf board. Use the Arduino as a reference so that you can find the shortest paths. The other side of the resistor array needs to be connected to 3 separate GPIO pins of the Arduino and also to the 2 data lines and the switch data line of the encoder. Write down which GPIO pins you decided to use. Add the pin headers afterwards. I only had 10 pin ones, but that won't make a difference in this case, because all the connections can still be made. Then connect all the cables from the step before and don't forget to connect the 5V line of the encoder to the 5V pin of the Arduino. Now that the hardware is done, let's start writing the software. To allow the Arduino to communicate with a host computer, you will need to use an external library which implements the HID protocol. Simply download this library as a zip archive and then put it in your Arduino IDE's libraries folder. I wrote this short test program to check whether it actually works. The simple program counts up and down according to the movement of the rotary encoder. You can reset the count by pushing the button. I defined the input pins in the setup method and in the main loop I read the input values and then check which of them have changed. I added several debounce delays and other protective code because my switch and rotary encoder were pretty cheap and tended to deliver false readings. You can see that I had to read both data pins to check which direction the encoder got rotated to. This type of encoder uses 2 binary digits and it doesn't know what exact state it is in. It can only tell the Arduino if it got rotated and in which direction. When the shaft gets rotated to the left, data 0 is low and data 1 is high. If it gets turned to the right, data 0 is high and data 1 is low. If it doesn't get rotated at all, both pins will remain low. If both pins are high, the encoder entered an undefined state. Upload the test program and run it. You can see that the encoder works properly and I can increase and decrease the values displayed on the screen. When I push the button, the count gets reset. Now that we made sure the encoder works, let's take a look at the final firmware, which will control the volume instead of displaying a count. As you can see, the firmware is almost the same as the test program from before. I just imported the Nikehood library and started the consumer service in the setup. Then I changed what happens with the readout of the encoder. This firmware tells the PC to reduce or increase the volume. It can also tell the PC to pause and resume playback when the button is pressed. Upload this code and test it with your computer. Now that the volume knob is functional, let's make sure it looks good. Like mentioned before, I'll 3D print the case for this project. To do that, I created this design in Tinkercad. I started by measuring all sides of the Arduino and the rotary encoder. Then I copied the measured values into Tinkercad and designed this bottom piece, which will hold the Arduino, and this center piece that will house the rotary encoder and the cables. The case itself will be held together by 4 screws, which will then be hidden under this rotating top piece. When I was satisfied with the design, I exported each part individually and printed all of them. After the prints were finished, I test fitted the Arduino and the rotary encoder and everything fits. So now it's time to assemble the volume knob. Mount the encoder and the Arduino in the case and close it with 4 screws and nuts. Finish the build by putting on the top piece. If everything was done correctly, all the components should fit nicely into the case. And just like that, your very own USB volume knob is done. If you don't want your knob to be made out of plastic, you could also create one that's made out of concrete and wood, like I did here. This one surely does have a very unique and expensive look and feel, but you can also tweak the firmware to create an accessibility device, which could, for example, replace a mouse scroll wheel. From here on, it's up to you what you do with your new volume knob. Now, if you would please excuse me, I'm going to listen to some music.